I got to tell you something. This isn't Bravo Sierra. This is real-time warning. And here's the thing that people don't understand. This is how they're working across the country. They, the powers that be that are going to put us under martial law, are buying off, bribing, and giving bonuses, if you will, to people that tell on people. I mean, this is just so out of control. And I, my
and Steve, they are targeting economically destitute areas where people are willing to go along to get along. Next segment coming up with Steve Quayle. It's the Alex Jones Show. I'm Jason Bermas sitting in. The latest over at Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.tv. I'm Jason Bermas sitting in. Alex on the ground in Hardin, Montana, getting the tour from Becky Shea, the front person, the spokeswoman for all of this, only divulging so much. A very nice, well-meaning lady. But we've got a ton of well-meaning idiots out there that are allowing this progression to occur. I really hope that she decides it's not enough to just go along to get along, and she realizes that this is a violation of the Constitution and Bill of Rights. This is against everything that Americans who believe in those documents stand for. Steve, can you just give us a quick overview of how this has developed over the last week, and then the FBI ties you just discussed with me off air?
Well, I think the thing that people need to understand real quickly is this has been developing, especially in Hardin, Montana, over the last probably year primarily, and economically destitute areas, not just in Montana, but in other states that can be used for training of foreign mercenaries, and let's call them what they are, Jason. Who are these mercenaries going to be used against? I think this is what the big picture that's being lost in. Well, is it really going in Hardin or not? All those of you that are sending all these emails saying, well, it's not really true or blah, 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 what you don't understand is that the idea simply is this, to preposition the troops that all of us have been warning about for years, and not only the ones that are currently prepositioned throughout the country, but when the declaration of martial law is declared either by a weapon of mass destruction over Washington, D.C., New York, London, wherever it proceeds from, or it's the biological plague generated in the laboratory, in which, by the way, Jason, two more bio agents of world renown have just been murdered in the last 2 weeks. Murdered. The idea is this, ladies and gentlemen, that we're talking about a reservation town, Hardin, Montana, that's been hit by incredibly, incredibly bad economics. We have a good idea. There was a $27 million prison built there. Basically, it did not meet state specifications. Our governor and I think one of our our senators were sued to be able to allow the private utilization of that prison. Now, isn't it interesting that the only prison that could be utilized, at least the only available prison, is in Hardin, Montana, which happens to be on a reservation, which fits the same category as Guantanamo Bay, which basically Alex brought up.
Yeah,
the
absolutely.
The presence of foreign troops in the state of Montana, Jason, is overwhelming, okay? We've got Helena, Montana, our capital, welcoming troops from Tajikistan. We've got the bases. We've got one of the biggest former SAC bases, and we've got one of the major Air Force bases in the whole United States, Maelstrom Air Force Base, with who knows what's going on up there, and that's in Great Falls. And then we've got the reports of 7,000 mercenaries of Blackwater being hired to secure the Montana border against people fleeing the United States into Canada when it all comes down. So we've got all of this being focused right now on Hardin, Montana. And as Alex said, hey, you just said it too. We've got a felon who seems to be the front man. But when we go beyond the front men, when we go beyond the front women, and we get to the heart of the matter, we've got the potential to have a very, very major strategic placement of foreign troops, mercenaries, and quite candidly, the money that it brings in is nothing. That's the other thing I didn't get a chance to ask Becky, is where does all this money come from? Because what we're looking at is basically very sophisticated funds. We're looking at a model where you basically come in and buy the population, economically distressed areas, and they're doing the same thing, by the way, in major cities across the United States in giant warehouses. So we're at the point now where the timetable has been ramped and amped up. How much time do we have?
We got about 60 seconds in this segment. On the other side, Steve, I want you to discuss how far this goes. I mean, is this a federal program? We've heard Obama say we need a police force that's just as strong, just as well-funded as the military. We've seen the youth corps being rolled out through city year. We've seen the economy becoming crushed as they announce a carbon tax. We've seen them say, no, there aren't mandatory vaccinations, but the military has mandatory vaccinations. And, oh, there's mandatory vaccination at the school, too. We are losing this country. Back after this, it's the Alex Jones Show. We are back live. It's the Alex Jones Show. I'm Jason Bermas sitting in as Alex is on the ground at Hardin, Montana, getting a tour of this Two Rivers facility. USA Today, the Boston Herald, the Associated Press have all picked up on this story. This is being run not by my words, but by the Billing Gazette and other, by a hardened criminal, a multiple felon, somebody who uses multiple aliases. This screams of a globalist operation, but I'm going to give it to Steve Quayle to break down how far down the rabbit hole this actually goes. Steve?
Well, it's interesting because you've done such a wonderful job, Jason, of telling people about, look, we've heard the words from the presidential administration that they want a private police force. We're now seeing everything that we saw in and I say this, in the time between the breakdown of the German economy, the Weimar Republic, and the rise of the National Socialists known as the Nazis, we're seeing such a parallel, and we're also seeing the introduction of foreign troops into this country on unimagined levels. Everybody, Jason, as you know, you guys have been reporting on it on your radio show and on your website. I mean, the amount of military transportation, there are people that are high-ranking military officials are telling me they've never seen such a thing like this, even in the build-up to the first Gulf War. Nothing like this has ever occurred. The idea that the black helicopters, how about the situation in Tennessee, where the 101st Airborne, I believe, is, you know, dropping in on a little town, and did you see the operational plan for that? They're seeking one individual. Come on, you don't drop in 340 paratroopers or whatever the final count is to go after one guy, or do you? Let me tell you what I'm being told. I'm being told now that the FBI director has gone to major cities and been telling them to prepare. The special agents in charge, or the SACs, are being told, get ready. So I don't know the timetable, but they seem to know the timetable. I have been told from deep pool, from people deep on the inside, that the fact is that bounties are being given for military to inform on other high-ranking military members that won't go along with the anti-constitutional, basically, grab for the government. I'm being told that even in police departments, Jason, that now a lot of the law enforcement officers that listen to Alex, listen to myself, listen to others that are warning, are starting to notice the presence of high-ranking, and in many cases, people that outrank them, foreigners, inserted into their law enforcement departments to seemingly be observers. We're being told that a $500,000 bounty is being offered for, again, that's $500,000, ladies and gentlemen, for people to inform on military people, to inform on each other, high-ranking police to segregate out and designate out what they're calling resistors. I've been told by people that were recently at Fort Bliss as early as Monday of this week, that when the military is getting ready to deploy to Iraq, they'll have a federal official walk in, and this literally happened, and make the statement, I hope there are no Tea Party members here. And one brave American soldier stood up and said, sir, I am, and I will defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic, and all the men applauded and stood with that man. That's at Fort Bliss at the beginning of the week. So what's happening is this. It's obvious. It's right in front of our face, and the idea of the orchestrated meltdown of the economy, all this is linked. The genetically altered viruses, H1N1, H5N1, all of this stuff, the Ebola smallpox, the Spanish flu, the dead scientists, it's all coming in. This is not a conspiracy. This is happening now. And so the point is that as Alex is saying, and he's in Hardin, Montana, and ladies and gentlemen, again, I tell you, pray for his safety. Pray for his safety. The idea is that the mainstream is finally getting a clue. And by the way, for those of you that are big-time Webbot fans, you know, predictive linguistic software, this is a fulfillment of that which is coming to pass. And people are now sensing, Jason, that they can identify what's going on. This uneasy feeling, I don't know how many people you talk to a day that actually get it and say, hey, I'm finally getting it. But people are finally getting it. And I believe that, obviously, what we're seeing right now in Hardin is only, if you will, the head, and I'll use it, a pimple. It's the pus that everybody's got to understand.
It's the acclimation of the American public to the police state.